Good day, Tinkercad friends, and welcome to the toy train tutorial that I mentioned a few days ago and that you helped me choose using Instagram. Once again, if you want to follow me on Instagram, there will be other posts there where you can help me pick what content we're going to do. You can also add comments to this post to help me figure out what we're going to do as well, as I like to create things that you guys are interested in using. Without any further ado, let's name our file Toy Train and let's get to work on building a cute little adorable toy train. The first step for our toy train is to bring out the box and take that box and let's change its measurements. I would like to make it 70 by 30 on each of these measurements. And then I would like to take the height and I'd like to make it 25. And then so that my wheels have a gap between the tracks and the vehicle, I'm going to raise it up 5 pieces. I also like when these corners are a little rounded, so I'm going to put a radius of 1. And now the main body of my train is in place. I'm going to nudge it over 1 millimeter so that it's lined up on a grid line. And then I'm also going to line it up with a grid line up in the front. That just makes life easier as I build. And now I'm going to add my wheels. I'm going to start by doing W, which is the work plane, so I can attach the wheels to the side. And then I showed in an earlier video how to use the awesome wheel that comes with Tinkercad. When yours loads, I have found that I prefer, and you can try all the different ones, I prefer a size 5. I like to keep the bore hole. I like to set the tire depth for 2 for my train wheels. You do need to wait for these to load or it'll lose track of itself. I'm going to make my wheels black as I go. I'm going to set the rim depth to 8. I'm going to set the center bore to 2.5. Once again, though, I'm going to wait until it's finished. 2.5. And you can mess with these numbers as much as you want. It's up to you. I'm just making them how I want them. I'm going to make my tires 4 wide, and I'm going to leave my edge radius. Now I'm going to use my arrow keys to nudge that till it's touching 0. And to make sure I'm touching 0, I'm going to do W to shut off. And then when I look at this side and I raise it up and down, you can see that now it's on 0. I can still use left and right to move my wheels where I want. And then I'm going to do Control D. Notice it blinked. That means I've got a second wheel. I'm going to move that to where I want it on the vehicle, and then I'm going to do Control D one more time, and then this one I'm going to shrink. So I click Fit View to Selection to zoom in. I'm going to hold the Shift key, and I'm just going to make it quite a bit smaller because I want to. I do want you to understand that my vehicle is not going to have wheels that move. They're going to just be attached to the side. That's how I'm choosing to make this, because it's just a toy train. If you want to make yours more real, that can be another project. When you've got yours lined up just the way you want, I'm going to tweak mine just a little. I'm going to group those 3 wheels, so I'm holding down Shift and selecting each one. And I'm going to hit Group. I'm going to do Control D to duplicate that group. I'm going to look at my vehicle from the top, and I'm going to move these to the other side. I'm going to switch to the top corner view, and then once I've got them lined up, notice the gap between this front wheel. We got to fix that by doing the flip tool. So now the wheels have been flipped on each side. I don't want these to move anymore, so I'm going to lock them, and I'm going to do the same thing on the other side because they are now permanently done. And now I can continue to build all my other parts and it won't mess with that. Let's add a cow catcher to our train at this point. Let's go back to our basic shapes. Let's set the work plane by clicking W and clicking on the front. And let's drop our cow catcher on front of our vehicle. I want you to change its across dimension to 21, and that's because I've done a little bit of math for you. And then I want you to bring out a box, and I need you to change a few of its measurements. First, let's make it 2 millimeters thick. Then let's make it 30 millimeters high. And let's change the depth of it to 16 millimeters. Now if we use our arrow keys, we can nudge it right over to the side, and we can lift it up so it pokes out, and we want to move over 1 millimeter. And then we want to use the sweet little cone to pull it out 2 millimeters. So what this will do is it'll cut that nice groove in our cow catcher. Now, I did some math for you. If we do Control D and move over 1 2 millimeters and then put a 1 millimeter gap between them, now it records that and we can do Control D and make those all the way across and have the same measurements on every side. You can see here I missed my math and I don't have my 1 millimeter on that side, but that's what's so cool is I can click on the blue one and I can just pull it out 1 millimeter, and now I do. We want our cow catcher all grouped, so just simply draw a box that only touches the cow catcher and its 7 little holes we're cutting out, and then group it so that our cow catcher is now one piece. Once you've got your cow catcher beautiful, then you can shrink it to the size that looks best on your vehicle, whatever you want. And then we always need to, I'm going to shut off W, so go back to the normal work plane. I'm going to grab just the cow catcher and the body, and I want to align those, and I always want them centered. So now it's looking a little bit more like a choo-choo train. Now let's add a platform for the train operators to walk around above the wheels, because sometimes they do have to do that when the vehicle's moving. Once again, use your work plane to drop your next piece on top. That next piece is a box. We want to make it 1 millimeter thick. And remember, our vehicle is 30, so let's make this 36 wide. So there'll be 3 millimeters on each side. And let's take the length and let's just use the handle and stretch it out so that it meets that front edge or is close. And then we want them to be able to go over the back as well. I'm going to take this piece and I'm going to turn it blue because that's a cooler color for my piece of train. It's even Thomas the Train blue. And I'm going to give him a rounded edge of 2 as well. And I'm going to move him forward one chunk. I'm happy with the middle of my train, so I'm going to select just the center. I'm not touching those wheels. And I am going to group those. And then I'm going to click the color, and I'm going to turn on multicolor, so that way they still look cool even though they're one part. Time to add a cab to our train. Let's press W so that we're on top of the blue piece. Let's bring out our cab. And let's change its measurements to 30 by 30. I'm going to hold shift and I'm going to just drag until it says 30 by 30. Because I'm keeping my toy train fun, let's make it rounded with a size of 2. Let's duplicate that little fella. And we'll make the second one a hole. But we're going to shrink it from 30 down to 28. That means there'll be 1 millimeter on each side. I'm going to take those two pieces and I'm going to align them center, center, and center. And then even though I can't see it, when I group those, I have just cut out the inside of my cool train. Let's shut off the work plane. Okay, friends, let's make a door for the back of our train. I want mine to be a cube with a rounded roof. So first I'm going to start with the cube. I'm going to shrink it to 16 wide. This is important so that you remember how big to make the next piece. I'm going to set the work plane on top of that, and I'm going to grab the nifty little round roof. And like I showed you a minute ago, we're going to just make it 16 wide. Turn it into a hole, grab both pieces, and then when you align those, make sure you center them and center them so that they're totally lined up. Group the two of them, and now they are one nifty piece. And when you press W, let's set our work plane to the top of the blue. That way we know how I'd raise this. So when it shows you 0, that means you're at the exact right height. And then you can just use the arrow keys to nudge it in. Now you can see that's going to be too high, but since it's grouped, I can just shrink it down and I can adjust it to the exact size that makes me happy. I'm going to grab those two parts and I'm going to center them because I want my door to be centered. When I'm happy, I hit group and check it out. I now have a cutout opening into my cool cabin. I don't like that it's running into that edge like that, so I'm going to ungroup and I'm just going to raise it up 1 millimeter. And I think that'll solve that and it'll look even cooler. Yes, that is what I'm shooting for. Now let's add windows real quickly. I'm going to shut off the work plane. I'm going to bring out a hole for the window. I'm going to make it plenty wide, so it's like 40. Doesn't matter. I just want it plenty wide. And then I'm going to shrink it down to a size that I think is good for the back of my vehicle. So I'm going to do 15 by 15. Once again, going to make sure that it's super wide. I'm going to just line it up with my eyes because I don't care if it pokes out a little bit. And then I'm going to lift it up. Let's take a look from the side in the corner to see if it's where we like it. I'm going to say nope. But that is where I like it. I'm going to pull it up to that height. And then this is what's so sweet is if you group them, you just cut out a sweet window into your train. I'm going to make a small engineer's window using the same trick. You can see here I just adjusted my numbers till I was happy. It still sticks out plenty far. When I grab only those two pieces, notice I can count that there's two. I can group them and I've cut out that window. And now I just need a window in the front of my vehicle, which I'll do with the same trick. Except this one I want to be less than 30 so that it doesn't take up the whole window. Let's lift it up to the height that we want. I'm going to use the cone to lift it up. I'm going to turn around and look at my vehicle from the front. And now I can nudge that across, and I'm using the arrow keys to pull it into place. I think that's a good place for my window. I might raise it up one or two. I am going to make sure it's centered using the center tool, and it is. So now I can group those two shapes, and my cab of my train is now beautiful. Check that little critter out. You can, of course, make yours as custom as you want. You can add steering wheels inside, but I'm only getting you the start on this and then hoping for you to make the awesome adjustments to really reach incredible levels. Let's add the cylinder to our train using the work plane on the front of the vehicle and then just bringing the cylinder out. And then I'm going to let you stretch it however big you want. I'm going to go 28. I'm going to pull it out to the front of the vehicle. And then because I have my work plane there, I can use the down arrow to nudge it into place. I'm going to pick that location. I'm going to back it up to that spot. I'm going to press W to shut off the work plane and click the blue area. Then I'm going to select just that top piece and I want to center those two. You can select the sides and make it as round and as smooth as you want or as blocky as you want. I'm going to make mine super smooth. I'm going to give it a tiny bevel just because I think that looks cool up front. Then I'm going to press W and I'm going to add the cool front end to mine. I'm going to use the half sphere and I'm going to attach it because of that work plane. And then I'm going to just eyeball this by holding shift and stretching it out till it fits the way I want. When I'm happy, shrink the front end of it. You could add all kinds of decorations like eyes, nose, and a mouth. But you can see that is looking pretty wicked. Let's add a smokestack and let's make sure that it's straight by setting our work plane to the blue ridge that we let them walk across. Let's bring out a cylinder and then I'm going to let you hold shift to shrink that to the size you want it to be. And I'm going to ask you to lift it up in the air so that it's going to be poking out. When you're happy with your size of your smokestack and you can pick whatever you want, I'm going to go with 10. I'm going to use the arrow keys to nudge it along where I want, and then I'm going to make sure that it's centered by once again clicking that whole chunk of pieces and clicking the center button to line it up. Since it's a smokestack, I need it to have a billowing edge coming out. I'm going to do that with the cone and the Sweet Work Plane tool. When you bring the cone out, it lets you type in the numbers. We know that that piece was 10 on the bottom, so if we do a radius of 5, then it'll match exactly. I'm going to grab just those two pieces, and I'm going to center them over each other. Click, click. And then I'm going to change its top value. Instead of 0, I'm going to make it 10. And then I'm going to shrink the distance to 6. You can put any number you want, but that's what I'm choosing. So there's my smokestack. I'm going to, instead of using 10, I'm going to try 8. That way it's a little easier for my dude to see around it. And I'm going to shrink that to 4. I'm going to press W again and do that same process. Bring out another cone. Set that base radius at 8 and the top radius at 4. Then I can grab my two pieces and use the align tool to straighten them up. There's that center button. Let's do that one more time. I'm going to grab all of those pieces now, and I'm going to do center again and center again. I want to cut out the smokestack, so I'm going to do another cylinder up top. There's my W. There's my cylinder. Now I need to shrink it to size 6 on a side so I can push it into the smokestack. I'm going to have the smokestack go quite a ways down, and I'm going to push it in. Then I'm going to grab all of those nifty little parts, and I'm going to center them. With those all put together, I'm going to group them. I'm going to turn on the multicolor. I'm going to add something fancy. I'm going to put little tubes just to make it look a little more cool. On that same work plane, I'm going to bring out a torus. I'm going to make its tube 0.75, so it's nice and skinny. I'm going to move that tube over close to the area. I'm going to make sure it's lined up by doing center and center. And now when I push that tube down, it pokes out really slick, making a nice ring around the smokestack. I'm going to do Control D and push down the second one, and then I'm going to hold down Shift, and I'm going to shrink it as it goes in, making sure that I hit a line on all the spots. Pop, pop, and that is pretty darn sharp. There are so many options for how you can customize your train. You can see I added a quick roof to my train. There's no limit to what you can do. I just wanted you to have the ability to make a cool train. I'm going to shut off Workplace so we can check it out. Make sure you remember this is not printable as far as the wheels being able to move, but it is fun for you to learn how to design, and then maybe after you've got the ideas for how to build a train, then you can start completing your own that would actually have movable wheels and all those other fun things. I hope you had a ton of fun with this cool little project. There's a lot of room for you to tweak and improve. You can see here that I don't have mine centered anymore. But I can real quickly just click on that, and boom, it is back in business. Appreciate you guys watching the video. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below. Make sure if you get a chance, you click the subscribe button. And if you want to be the first to know when the next HLModTech training movie appears, click the bell. Have a great day, friends. Thanks for tinkering.